Good evening all. So today we will talk about the installation of NS-3. It's a network simulator version 3. It's a open source network simulator tool which is for simulation. So before going to that, we will see the difference between NS-2 and NS-3. NS-2, we have the network simulator version 2. The advancement of NS-2 is NS-3. So simply go to the website https://www.nsman.org. This is authorized website for NS3, and you can download the source code for NS3 from this website. So the latest version for NS3 is NS3.26, and the main important difference is NS2, you can download the software from NS-2 version, and for NS3 you can download the software in terms of NS-3. This version will be different. NS-2-NS-3, the versions were different. Okay, so if you want to download this source code, you go to this website nsman.org and you can go to this download link. You can download the software, the tar file for this network simulator. So I have downloaded already in this software, so I don't want to download the software again. So before going to install the Network Simulator 3, we want to install some of the basic configuration files for NS3. So these are the simple configuration files for the NS3 simulator. We need a GCC compiler, that is C++ compiler, because the NS3 were designed by C++ coding, and we need a Python configuration files, and we need a Mercurial, and we need a Flex, a Bison tool, and for SQL and some of the packages for it. So the first step is to copy this configuration file, and you can paste it into the terminal and just press enter. So it takes some time. It needs some 714 MB of hard drives. Normally it takes some time, minimum of 20 minutes to maximum of 40 minutes, depends on your internet speed, it will be downloaded. So already I had downloaded this one, so I don't go for no. If you are supposed to download the software, you just press enter. Yes, why, you can press for downloading a fresh installation. For no, already I don't want to install again and again. Okay, so this is the first step you can do. Next step, if you want to tar our NS3 folder, so my NS3 folder means in the download folder. We can start from NS all-in-one 3.26. So my software is NS 3.26. so what I can do is my folder is in downloads. I can go to my download folder, downloads. In the download folders, I have already downloaded my NS3, so here is the NS-3.26 folder. Simply you can NS all-in-one 2.36.bz to file is there. So NS-2.3 is there, and NS-3.26 is, this is NS all-in-one 2.35 for NS-2, this folder, and this folder for NS-2, and this is the folder for NS3, because my version will start from NS-3.26.bz2, and I have already extracted this tool. So if you want to extract the tool, you go to tar xpf. You know tar is a tap archive file. I want to extract this x and verbose and fr file, and NS-3.26.bz. So I am extracting this using this command, and finally I will get my folder NS-3.26. This is the way we can do for installation, first installation of NS. So I am going to the folder. So I have the folder, I'm in the NS-3.6 folder. So we'll go to NS-3.66 folder, and you can put a command of ls can put a command of ls. So you have your Python coding and you have the basic codings, basic configuration files for your NS-3. Next step is we want to build a Python, because the NS-3 were designed by the Python code. So we just press dot backslash dot Python. So it will be so all the configuration files which we have installed in the first step. The first step we have installed the basic configuration files. All will be checked here, and those who are not enabled, it will show the not enabled way, and those are the folder we are enabled. So it needs some 1937 configuration files we must check. It will be checked by the Python, and it will take some time, because for fresh installation it takes some time, but for my installation it will be very fast, because I am again and again browsing this MS3 for coding, so it will be very fast. And it's a very good tool for your networking simulation, like your UDP protocol, internet protocol and TCP protocol. And want to do the simulation part of your, just want to do the simulation using AODV, TCP, IP, FTP protocol, and different types of protocols which is using the networks, we can do it here. And just want to do their research in mobile ad hoc networks, wireless networks and all. You can easily testbed your software codings here. It is easily will be implemented here using C++ coding. So this is a way we can compile the NS3 coding here. And the main step is you have two important. One is we need a network animation which can be defined by Python, and you want to build a program using Scratch file. So it takes some time. So if any doubts you have in the NS3 simulator, you go to this website and you have a lot of documentation is there, tutorial parts is there, and tutorials and documentations are there, and you have netanning tool, and you have NS2 and written tutorials in the HTML PDF format, and all these materials are available in this website. You want to do the tutorial parts, you can easily go to this website, and you have all those things which is readily available on this website. If you have any queries, you can see this website very easily, and how the installation to the programming techniques for MS3 are there. So totally 1829 packages were compiled as it of 1937 packages. So this is the way we can we can do the packages. So all the configuration files to be built by here. So your network animation file can be created using this command qmac netanim.pro, and you are giving the Mac, and the Mac directory which was created, and our file will be in the netanim 3.10. So all the files can be built, and I will get the configuration files to take some 7 minutes 46 seconds, and after completion of this installation the following modules were built, and so we'll have the directory ns3.26 here. So ns3.26, so here we'll go to the directory. Once again I'll go to the directory cd space ns3.26. So inside your ns3.26 you have the execution file of ns3 is there. So this is the way configuration file. This is the WAF is the configuration file for to run your that is for executing your ns3.\WAF. So these are the this file can be the important file for executing your ns3 simulation. So all the models were built, so it takes some 13 seconds time, and these are the OpenFlow is the newest network. OpenFlow is the network tool which can be built. We have the virtual bridges and all this tool, Ethernet tools, etc. We have implemented using this OpenFlow. And the next thing is, we want to create a network animation file for NS3. So which is in the NS3.26 folder, I think which is in the NS32.36. So we just press ls. So in this we have cd netanim 2.1.0. So we'll go to the directory cd netanim 3.170, and we can type ls. So these are the so in that we have a file is called netanim file. So you want to use a file for executing the network animation. So which is in the network animation, so go to the directory, you will execute this by .\ netanim. Yeah, this is the window for a network animation window for executing the program. Okay, so I need a XML file for executing this XML. So I don't have any XML file here. So if you want XML file, suppose for I need a XML file for network animation tool. So what you can do is go to the terminal. Control C and cd \\. So we'll go to the directory cd ns3.26.\WAF. Some of the basic file are there in the debug folder, in the debug part. Enable examples. So in the examples folder we have the dumple animation file we have not. We have some things called the spelling is correct for \ run, and we have temple animation. So you can, you have any queries, we can see this. So I think so we want to configure. So I have done the so I'm so the debug configure, we must in configure the file. So that's a problem we have. So we didn't configure that file. So first we must configure the file. Once the configuration is over, next we can. Run this file. So after completion of this process, you will get this dumbbell animation XML file. So it will be executed very fast, don't worry. And for new installation, it will be take some time. And for after installation over, it will be very easy to process all those Python execution. So we want to configure some 2364 Python configuration packages. So after configuration, and we have created this dumbbell animation file, the XML file for all the protocol configuration will be implemented. So we have CSMA, OBB, and DSDB protocol, internet protocol, and some dynamic source routing, mesh, linked state routing, and some of the point-to-point protocol, point-to-multipoint protocol. So we have created the animation trees file called dumbbell-animation.xl. Okay. So you can give the dumbbell animation files we have created here. So ls, you can type ls. So we have created this animation file, which is in the NS-3.26 folder. Okay, NS-3.26 folder. So we go to the cd netminding 3.17.backslash work animation files. So we go to the dev folder ns. So we go to the folder ns3.26. in this ns3.26, and we have the file called dumbbell-animation.xl. open this file. So this is the animation file for the XML file. So we have some 65,538 bit size, the mode size is 1, and we have run this file using this button. So I am sending my UDP protocol here, so it will reach the destination. Depends on the more number of paths, so we can increase in this simulation. So increase the simulation speed. So if it is network is unreachable, then shows ICMP, internet control message protocol, destination host unreachable. So we will increase in the speed. So here you have left corner, you have the mouse position and the battery capacity, and you have the so the nodes, how much node, the position for the node, description of the node, so its MAC address, IP address, and then executed. So my starting IP address is 10.3.1.N1, and we have the more number of IPs, version IP address to be here. We can be we can process, and we have the simulation restart option, and for this ID for the which will be reset to the original position here, and we can increase in this graph, and we can decrease, and it will apply this for internet protocol with the setup, internet protocol setup for the IP address setup for the initial address and starting address and destination address, and we can implement the MAC protocol also, MAC address. We can implement this MAC address using this. So we can implement this MAC address also, and we have this. So packets destination. So this shows the packet destination from starting node and to the node, and how much transmission time it takes. Transmission time. So how much second it can go, and its metadata. Okay. So this is the way we can do for this graph. So we must show the graph for each and every TCP. We can show it. So we can submit this TCP, and for UDP we can submit this. For IPv4 we can submit this, and for ICMP we can submit this, and for Wi-Fi we have this, and for Ethernet for this. Suppose I want Wi-Fi alone, so what will be the graph? So click Wi-Fi and select. And for IPv4 we can submit this. So this way we can do this analysis in a graph, and it should be very useful for the research peoples. And this is the way the module where the node 1 and node 2, where their IP, starting IP and their MAC address and other things and all implemented in the statistics. Node 1, node 2 and so on, node 11. So we are using this node 11, up to node 11 we have implemented. So we can implement these packages. So this is a way we can go for network installation 3 with their animation, example animation. So in the next few videos we will be discuss about the programming techniques for Network Simulator 3. We will be discussing the next session. So thank you very much.